Hello and good afternoon once again, kids. I'm back here with a short tutorial video for class 7 maths. And today our topic is multiplication of fractions. We'll be dealing few sums regarding multiplication of fractions. As you might have gone through the previous video as well, we have finished the addition and subtraction. So now comes the second part of the fraction, that is multiplication of fractions. So it's basically in your exercise 3D, so we'll be dealing with the multiplication of fractions. So the first sum in here that we have in regarding multiplication of fractions is that from exercise 3D, question number 1 is that we got 1 divided by 5 into minus 5 divided by 6. So regarding multiplication of fractions, what is the main important thing that you need to know is that the numerator and the denominator, remember, the numerator and the denominator, they can be cancelled of the similar fractions or the fractions opposite to one another, that is with the multiplication sign. So what I've done here at the first question is I have got the first question as 1 divided by 5 into minus 5 divided by 6. So this numerator with this denominator, since it was 5 and 5, so 5 1 times is 5, 5 1 times is 5, they can be cancelled with 5. So I've cancelled them with 5. And as soon as all the cancellation processes are finished, remember, we need to, first of all, we need to multiply the signs. So for the first fraction, we don't have any sign. And what we know about the sign is that if no signs are there, that means it's a positive integer, isn't it? So plus into minus. So plus into minus, it's minus. So, and remember, the multiplication goes similar. It is that numerator into numerator, denominator into denominator. Remember, the multiplication goes for just numerator and numerator, not numerator and denominator. Only the cancellation can be done with the numerator and the denominator. So for the first one, numerator and numerator, 1 into minus 1. We have minus 1 in here because it has been cancelled with 5. So plus into minus, it's minus. 1 into 1, it's 1. Again, we have 1 in the denominator for the first new fraction form, 1 in the denominator left. So 1 into 6, it is 6. So this is how it is done. Is it okay? It's easy, isn't it? Similarly, for the second question, that is question number 6, we have minus 13 divided by 21 into minus 63. It's given bracket minus 63. Also, the denominator is not given. So what do we know is, if the denominator is not given for the fractional form, we know that the denominator is 1. Isn't it? So again, the same thing happened. What I did here was I've opened up the bracket on the second step, so it is minus 13 by 21 as it is into minus 63. Now what do I see is 21 can cancel 63. 21 3 times is 63, so that's why I've cancelled it. 21 1 times 21, 21 3 times is 63. And as I said, after all the cancellations and all, first of all we need to multiply the sign because we are doing multiplication of fractional forms. And the numerator, so numerator into numerator, minus into minus, it's plus, no need to mention the plus sign. 13 into 3, it's 39. Is it okay? So I hope you have understood. It's an easy one, but kind of easy one, isn't it? So for the next one, for question number 11, we have 128 divided by 169 into minus 507 divided by 640. As I've already said, while doing the calculations and all, the negative sign has to be kept in the numerator, isn't it? So the second step we can do that, because since it's I've just directly copied the question. And what do I suggest is for greater numbers, for bigger numbers like this 128, 169, 640, 507, we cannot directly know the that whether they are divisible by this certain number or not, isn't it? Whether they are multiples of certain numbers or not. So what I did was, what I recommend is you take the prime factors of those numbers. See, for 128, I've taken all the prime factors of 128. Similarly, for 169, I've taken prime factors. 507, I've taken prime factors, as well as for 640, I've taken all the prime factors. Now, after that, what you can do is simply place the prime factors in its place. So, see what I've done here. For in place of 128, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 twos. So, I directly placed 7 twos in the numerator because 128 was a numerator, remember that. And similarly, 507 was a numerator. So, for 507, I have factors as 3. 13 and 13. So here I have 3 into 13 into 13. And it was multiplication. As I've already said, the signs can be multiplied at first. So minus into minus, I've already multiplied the sign first. So it's plus. So no need to mention plus. just to show you, I have written plus in here. Is it okay? So in the denominator, I have got 169 now. So 169, the factors were 13 into 13. So I place 13 and 13 in the denominator. For 640, it also was in denominator. For the second fractional form, the factors were 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 2s and 1, 5. So I place 7, 2s and 1, 5. Now what I can do is, as I've already said, you can cancel the numerators and the denominators. So from the numerator, 7 2s were there. So in the denominator, similarly 7 2s I had. So I've cancelled them. In the numerator, I had 2 13s, 13 and 13. Similarly in the denominator, also I had 2 13, 13. So I've cancelled. After cancelling all the terms, what's left in the numerator was 3. And what's left in the denominator was 5. So your answer is 3 divided by 5. Is it okay? Okay. So now for the next part of the question is from question number 2-1. So 2-1, it's in the mixed fractional form. Again, as I said, for mixed fractions, we cannot operate on mixed fractions. So first of all, mixed fractions has to be converted into improper fraction, isn't it? Mixed fraction is always converted to improper. So what I did in the first step was I converted mixed fractions to improper fractions, see, for the both the fractions. And as I said, the numerator and denominator, they can be cancelled, isn't it? So what do I see here is, since the numbers were smaller, so I didn't went for the prime factor method. So because, say, 7, 21, I know that 7 can easily cancel 21, isn't it? So 7, 1 times 7, 7, 3 times 21. Now what do I see is, but remember, this 3 and this 9, they can be cancelled. They cannot be cancelled because both the terms, they are in numerator, isn't it? So what's next? So we need to multiply the numerators. We need to multiply the denominator since there were no common factors. So 3 into 9, it's 27. 4 into 1, it's 4. 27 by 4, since it's already in the simplest fractional form, so either whether you convert it or not, it will the answer stands the same, isn't it? So if you want to convert it or go to mixed fractional form, so your answer for the mixed fractional form will be 6, 3 divided by 4. Or either you can keep your answer in the improper fraction as it is. It's because it's already in the simplest fractional form, isn't it? So similarly, let's go with question number 2-2. Again, I have here two mixed fractional forms multiplying a negative term and a positive term. So 6, 4 times 24, 24 plus 5 is 29, so 29 divided by 6 it is, into 9, 7 times 63, 63 plus 1, 64, 64 divided by 9. What do I see in the do I see afterwards was, see, this 6 and 64 both are multiples of 2, they can be cancelled with 2, so 2 3 times is 6, 2 32 times is 64. After that, what do I see is none of the terms, they can be cancelled, so I've simply multiplied the numerator. As I said, the sign needs to be multiplied first, so minus into plus, since second fractional form was a positive term, so minus into plus, it's minus, so 29 into 32, it's 928 divided by 3 into 9, it's 27 in the denominator. It's already in the simplest form, so we can keep our answer as it is, isn't it? So I hope you have understood till up to here. And now in the same question, we have got it's a little bit like simplification as well, because we got a bracket term and inside the bracket we got a negative sign as well. Not a negative sign, but a negative minus relation, that is subtraction of fractional forms we have. So what I did was, again, converted the improper mixed fraction to improper form. The within the brackets, as you know, from the Bodmer's rule, we know that whatever is term is there within the bracket, we need to operate it first. So I have operated it first, subtraction of fractional forms, taken the LCM, done all the process. You know LCM, how it is done, the subtraction of fractions, isn't it? Minus the last term, third term, as it is. So after all this, we have minus 90 divided by 91 in the middle term, that is the second term, third term, first term. And after that, what I have done is, I have went through the all the prime factors of the numerators, similarly the prime factors of the denominator. If you go with the prime factors, the chances of getting mistakes are very less, remember that. So from here and here, what happened here was, also I multiplied the sign as well, see, minus into minus, it's plus, isn't it? But I have got one more sign, so I need to multiply that as well. So plus into minus, it will remain as minus. So after taking all the prime factors, the sign remains same, that is minus. After taking all the prime factors, whatever I can cancel it, I have cancelled the terms. And after all that, I got my answer as minus 25 divided by 6. Since, as I said, it's already in the simplest fractional form, so you can leave your answer up to here, or if you want to convert it to mixed fraction form, then you can cancel it. So the answer will be 64 times is 24, so it will be 4 minus 4, 1 divided by 6, isn't it? And here we have a question about simplification of fraction. So see, what do I have here is, I've got multiplication as well as subtraction of fractional forms. I've got addition again and multiplication. So again, you know, according to the Bodmer's rule, what do we know is the bracket needs to be solved first, whatever is there within the bracket. So that's what I have done here. So first of all, it was in the mixed fractional form, so I've converted all the mixed fractional form to improper form. So after that, subtraction of fractions, so I've done subtraction of fractions in here, addition of fractions, I've done addition of fractions in here. So, and the multiplication term remain as it is. So after, I hope I don't need to explain the same thing again and again, because you know how the subtraction and addition is done of the fractional forms. So after that again, so what do I got here is multiplication of fractional forms, then whatever was there that I can cancel it, I've cancelled the terms. You know, as I've already said, we can cancel the denominators and the numerators. So after cancelling all that, I've got minus 105 divided by 2. So again, it was already in the simplest form. Yes, it can be converted to mixed fractional form. So those who wants to convert, they can convert, or you can leave your answer in the simplest fractional form. Is it okay? So I hope you have understood the multiplication of the fractional forms. So one more topic for today, that is of division of fractions. So for division of fractions also, again, the same thing will happen. It's same thing will happen. Worry not, it's also easier as compared to others. So it is 6.5 divided by minus 13. So in only the slight change in the division will be, you can convert the division sign to multiplication. See, what I've done here is, first of all, I've converted the mixed fractional to improper. Then I've converted the division sign to multiplication. And as soon as you convert the division sign to multiplication, what happens is the second term will be reciprocated. Remember, reciprocated. Reciprocal. What does reciprocal mean? The numerator will go to denominator and denominator will go to numerator. Since minus 13 has denominator 1, it was not mentioned, so we know that the denominator 1. So after reciprocal, I got my number as fraction as minus 1 divided by 13. So, and after that, what do I see here is numerator and the denominator for two fraction forms with multiplication relation, numerator and denominator were 13. So I've cancelled 13 and 13 and got our answer as minus 1 divided by 2. Is it okay? The simple thing in here to understand is that you need to convert the division sign to multiplication. So as soon as you convert the division to multiplication, the second term will be reciprocated. So, and the second question we have here, again, 5 divided by minus 16 divided by minus 15 divided by 16. So as I said, the negative sign has to be kept in the numerator at first. So I have in the second step, I've done the same thing, that is minus 15 by 16, converted the division sign to multiplication. As I said, what happens when we convert division to multiplication, second fractional form, it got reciprocated. Denominator went to numerator, numerator down to denominator, so it is minus 16 divided by 15. First of all, we need to multiply the sign, minus into minus, we have plus, no need to mention the plus sign. So what do I see here is 15 divided 16 into 16 divided 15. The numerators and denominators, they can be cancelled. So after cancelling all this, what do I got is 1, 1, 1, 1. So if you multiply 1 and 1, you'll get 1. Denominator also, you'll get 1. So no need to mention 1 in the denominator. We have learned that, isn't it? So you can just simply write your answer as 1. Is it okay? Okay, now for the next question, I picked from question number 6-2, that is, the fractional, mixed fractional form again with a bracket, division with a bracket, a term inside the bracket, and again mixed fraction. So I've converted the mixed fraction to improper fraction first, see, then converted the division sign to multiplication sign, reciprocated the second term, cancelled all the terms, got my answer as minus 13 divided by 8. Is it okay? So, and for question number 6, again, a little bit of simplification is also included there, because we had within the brackets we got two fractional forms with minus, that is subtraction of two fractional forms. So what I did here, again, see, I have gone with the cross multiplication part, the subtraction of the fractional forms. So after doing all that, I got my answer as minus 14 divided by 51 into, see, the division I have converted to multiplication into, reciprocated the term 136 by 105. Then after that, I have, since the numbers were large, so I have taken the prime factors of the numbers. And after taking prime factors, as I said, you can cancel the terms, like terms from the numerator and denominator. So I've cancelled the numerator and like terms from numerators and denominators and got my answer as 32 divided by 45. Here again, the same thing happened. First of all, I multiplied the sign, minus into minus, it's plus, and then everything the same, isn't it? The procedure is same. Then after that, what do I have is, for question number 72, a little more of simplification in here. See, the first mixed fractional form into, again, two fractional forms within the bracket with plus addition of fractions divided by, again, a fractional form within the bracket with a negative sign. So, again, mixed fraction converted to improper, addition of fractions within the bracket, LCM'd it, taken the addition of the fractions, this one, this term remained as it is, because it was simple, a mixed fraction, not a mixed fractional form, simple fractional form. It's a proper fraction, isn't it? The numerator is smaller than the denominator. Proper fraction with a negative sign, so kept it as it is. After here, after this, what I have done here, addition of fraction forms, I have opened up all the brackets, converted the division to multiplication, reciprocated the term, then cancelled all the terms, and finally got my answer as 4. See, again, first of all, the sign, plus minus into plus, it's minus, so minus into minus, it's plus, no need to mention the plus sign. All the terms, they can be cancelled. Denominator, there one left at the denominator. No need to mention one in the denominator again. So, here we have with 4 as our answer. Okay, so I hope you kids have understood today's lesson. Hope you kids are practicing and are safe in your home. So, keep on practicing. And the remaining sums will be your homework. If you haven't understood any, then you can let me know anytime. Thank you.